is horrible. As soon as I walked in, 2 seconds of talking, and she put this thing in my nose, right up my nostril, and I start choking. It's to numb my sinuses and my throat. Cause he's gonna go put a freaking tube down my throat. I'm not liking this at all. Oh God, not liking this. Here we go, guys. It's supposed to numb my throat and my nose, and it tastes horrible. Torture fucking chair. Oh, I don't feel good. I feel like I'm gonna throw up. Size hail, hammers, planes. I have a weather channel on here. Fancy. This is the torture chair.
Hello.
Jeff Adams.
We have a problem.
What's the problem?
Besides me being scared, I'm not numb anymore.
You're not numb anymore?
Okay. Okay.
We're going to torture you again.
Oh, thank you.
Are you having trouble swallowing or anything?
Right now? No. I mean, I do sometimes.
Sometimes you do?
Yeah, I choke.
Choking?
On anything. Everything.
Now you have been on thyroid hormone, 88.
Yeah, he reduced it to 80. It was 0.025. I've had 3 or 4 biopsies. I have like 3 nodules. I have a large one, I believe, on this side.
Mm-hmm.
Number 3, that's C to 40. Whatever.
Yeah.
Anyway, Dr. Moon said, instead of continually getting the biopsies, just be done with it. Because I'll have to keep going in and getting biopsies to make sure it's not turning into cancer. So, I guess he wants you to just take it all out.
Usually, we'll just do one side, you know, unless it's like an autoimmune attack,
mm-hmm.
or if it's a cancer or something.
Oh. Just one side of it. He's doing an uptake, or I'm doing an uptake on the 10th and 11th of July. So I guess he'll be able to see the function and stuff a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
So, yay, surgery again. I've had so many surgeries lately.
Now that last TSH level was low. So I'm assuming that's why he backed off of it, and see if he can repeat that when you go come back to him. Or
well, he wants me to stay off of it until I have that uptake test. I've been out for 4 weeks.
Okay. I would see what that shows, you know, before we recommend what surgery. That Bethesda 3.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's sort of in the gray zone. We can take it out. There's also some DNA testing that can be done on it, you know, if you didn't want to have surgery. Or you could just repeat it, you know, repeat the biopsy down the line and see if there's anything changed in it.
Yeah.
But if you're having choking and it's pressing on you, you probably just want to have it, you know, part of it removed anyway.
What are we doing now?
Look in your nose.
Oh, God.
Does your nose bother you at all?
I don't think so.
Wiggle your tongue. Good. Say hi.
Aw.
Aw. Let's all say. Take a breath in. Can't see the voice box.
I have no voice box.
What's that?
No voice box.
No voice box.
Real tender, like right along in here.
Not right, so. So, yeah, fullness. So it's more tender on the right side.
Mm-hmm, which is weird.
So if you swallow. Yeah, it feels a little more full on that right side and some tenderness. Alright, give you some more spray.
So many different things then. That's okay.
Well, your antibodies were good, so it didn't look like an autoimmune attack.
Oh, good.
And you have not had a biopsy in a year, right? That last one was pretty old.
Been about a year.
Did he mention repeating the biopsy? This is so
old. Dr. Mahmood?
Yeah.
No. Well, I came from California and was seeing an endocrinologist.
Oh, you just moved here from California?
Yeah.
Okay. Whereabouts?
From Victorville.
Victorville? What's that?
High desert. About San Bernardino. Are we doing
that? All right, so focus on slow deep breaths. A little bit of pressure. That little scarring. Take a swallow. And again. And again. Yeah, with the cleans. Got some mucus stuck on there.
I'm sorry.
No,
I'm
okay.
I didn't mean to produce mucus. I wish I could see what yours is.
Cool. Right, turn a little to the right. To the right.
Oh.
Okay, good. See the bass tone, moderate lingual tonsils. That flows good. Say
hee.
Got like moderate posterior hemipacky, retinoids are mildly inflamed. Piriform good. Hee. Cord's good. You have a little bit of laryngitis back there. Do you smoke at all?
No, I quit over 10 years ago.
Okay. It can be related to acid reflux.
Oh. When I had my endoscopy, my stomach is like up here where it's not supposed to be.
Oh, okay. Like a hiatal hernia?
Yes.
Who did that? Someone here or California?
California.
When did you move?
February. It must be cool looking through that tube. I've always wanted to videotape one of my surgeries. I'm fascinated by the human body.
It is pretty cool.
But I never get to see all the cool stuff.
You could YouTube laryngoscopy.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I call it flexible laryngoscopy or fiber optic laryngoscopy. Yeah. What do you take for that stomach issue?
Oh, God, here we go. I should have written down the medications. Omeprazole, I think.
Once a day or twice a day?
It's supposed to be twice a day. So one's time release, and the other one dissolves in water. And I've been really bad about taking it. That one coats my intestines.
Okay. Well, if you wanted to get back on it like every day for 2 months and see if that calms the choking down. Because that may be coming from, you know, inside from laryngitis rather than the thyroid. And since it's been so long since you've had the biopsy, I'd recommend repeat.
Do you do it?
No, I do it at the hospital. I have the radiologist do an ultrasound guided.
Okay.
That way they have a pathologist on site. They can look and make sure they get what they want. Yeah. So if all that looks good and we get your throat feeling better, you may not have to have thyroid surgery. You know?
No more surgery. Well, I'm already and having also another one next then this month.
Sorry. What other surgery?
Female surgery. Bye.
Yeah.
It doesn't even bother me.
Well, I hope that goes smoothly.
Thank you. I wasn't too bad, that little tiny tube. I mean, it was a little uncomfortable, but it wasn't too bad.
Okay. So I'll see you, excuse me, I'll see you back after the scan and then the biopsies.
Okay.
And so I will do the omeprazole twice a day, and then I'm not sure what that one you're dissolving is.
I can call back with all the medications.
Do you know to take it before your meals, the omeprazole? Works better if you do it like half hour or an hour before the meal.
Okay.
And then Zantac at bedtime would help.
I already take so much at bedtime.
Yeah.
Trenolax around 4. Clonazepam at bedtime, Seroquel. Iron at dinner time. I guess they're all okay.
Should be okay, yeah. Yeah, so we'll do 300 in Zantac. All right, Miss Lucia. Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
That wasn't too terrible. Well, not too bad. The numbing spray usually takes care of all of it.
When it kind of scraped, it was.
And then it just goes down. Yeah. Okay, what pharmacy we use?
Walgreens and Newport.
Do you have plenty of the omeprazole, or do you want me to send it as a prescription? And if the insurance don't cover it, you can always get it over the counter, so.
I could use some more.
Okay. I am going to send the ranitidine, so we might as well just send the other one too. So. Okay.
Should I call back with all the medications I'm on?
No, don't worry about it. I've got most of them listed from Dr. Mahmood, so.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're good. We won't worry about it. I got, like I said.
So you have all the ones.
I've got all the ones that was, yeah. So the ones that you didn't have listed, I left all the rest of them on there. Okay. When I did your packet. Okay.
So when I have the biopsy, they'll look at all the nodules?
They're going to look at both of them,
mm-hmm.
on both sides.
Okay.
And then we'll get the report off of that, okay? And then we'll get the report of the nuclear medicine scan. And depending on all that together, then we'll come up with whether we need surgery or not.
Does he ever just remove the nodules and leave the thyroid?
No, it had to be one side or the other taken out, or both. Yeah. Okay. So he would actually take out the whole gland itself, the lobe. Okay. And then if he has to take out both sides, he'll remove the whole thing. So, okay. I'm going to have Tanya schedule this up front as you check out.
Where will I have this done?
You'll have that done at Morristown Hamlin Hospital.
Here in Morristown?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. And we'll see you back after that's done. Okay? You're welcome. And then the uptake scan is on the 17th. Is that right?
No. It's the July 10th and 11th.
July 10th and 11th?
Yes.
July. I had that in there wrong. July 10th. Okay. So we'll see you back after July the 11th. Okay?
Should I call or?
No, she can schedule it as you check out. Right. Just tell her after July 11th.
Awesome.
When you have your other scan.
Thank you.
You're welcome.